for the best medical and paramedical lectures, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to stay connected with us.
Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel. Myself G. Today we will learn about claustrophobia. So let's get started.
Claustrophobia. Definition. The word claustrophobia is the combination of two words, a Latin word claustrum meaning closed in place and a Greek word phobos meaning fear. Claustrophobia is an anxiety disorder that causes an intense fear of enclosed spaces, an abnormal and persistent fear of closed spaces, of being closed in or being shut in, as in elevators, tunnels or any other confined space. In this condition, a person will have an intense fear of being stuck in small spaces. He will be afraid of being in an elevator, tunnel or any closed places. The person will also fear crowded places. Now let's discuss how does this occur. What are the things or places or situations due to which this condition arises? Many situations can trigger claustrophobia. Triggers may include being in a small room without windows, riding in airplane or small car, being in an elevator, undergoing a MRI, standing in a large but crowded room like a party or concert, or standing in a closet. The other places are public restrooms, car washes, doors, store dressing rooms, caves or tunnels. These are some pictures of the places that can trigger claustrophobia. Now, all of these pictures are of closed places. The person fears that he or she will get stuck in, so he panics and gets anxiety attacks. If you ever met a person having claustrophobia, whenever he or she is in a situation like this, he will say he needs some air. He is feeling breathless. It is because of this fear of being locked in or getting stuck. Next question will be, why would a person be afraid of getting stuck in these places? There are other people, they are not getting scared, but a claustrophobic will get excessive fear and he will be frightened in this situation. What are the causes of that? In many conditions, this happens because of past experiences. For example, a person may have experienced things in his childhood like being trapped or being kept in a confined space or being punished by getting locked in a bathroom, or even a person having a parent that has claustrophobia, he can get it by genes or hereditary. Having experienced turbulence when in an airplane or ever got separated from parents in large crowd. Other cause is dysfunctioning of amygdala. Amygdala is a small structure in the brain, but it is very important and necessary. It is needed for the conditioning of fear or the creation of a fight or flight response. So when the amygdala is dysfunctioning or is smaller in size than normal, the person suffers from claustrophobia. Symptoms of claustrophobia. Whenever the trigger will happen, there will be changes seen in behavior of patient. Those changes would be sweating, trembling, getting chills, shortness of breath, choking sensation, rapid heartbeat, feeling sick, headaches, feeling faint, numbness, dry mouth, a need to go to the toilet, ringing ears, feeling confused or disoriented. The patient will be disoriented, he will forget what he was doing and wouldn't be able to concentrate. Next is the diagnosis. There is not a specific test for the diagnosis of claustrophobia. There is no blood test or x-ray or anything because it's a psychotic disorder. So for that, consultation is required. But there are certain criteria which have to be met so that it can be declared as a phobia. These criteria are an interminable fear caused by existence or anticipation of a specific situation. Now, the situations that we discussed earlier, if those situations occur, there will be excessive fear seen in the patient. Anxiety response when stimulus is exhibited can result in panic attack. Means whenever this stimulus will get into a person's head, the person will be panicked. Maybe he can start crying also. Acknowledgement by adult patient that their fear stems from the anticipated threat or danger. The patient will feel like he is in a danger or he is being threatened. Whenever the situation will occur, the person will try to face it, but he will get anxious and discomfort will occur. The person's evasion of the object or situation impedes with everyday life and relationships. His everyday life and relationship may also get affected. And the phobia is continuous, usually for 6 months or longer. So the another thing from which we can identify that it is a phobia is it will be longer, 6 months or longer time period. Because there is a difference between fear and phobia. Phobia is continuous. Next is the treatment. This condition is mostly treated by psychotherapy. Generally, medications are given less and treatment is focused more on helping the patient to overcome his fear and manage the triggers. Treatment includes first cognitive behavioral therapy. In this therapy, the therapist will teach the patient how to control the negative thoughts whenever the situation occurs. By changing his thoughts, the reaction will change and he can overcome his fear. Second is rational emotive behavioral therapy. This is same as CBT. It focuses on emotions and behaviors and helps to accept positive and healthy beliefs. Third is relaxation and visualization. This technique includes exercises like counting from 10 to 1 or imagining a safe place. These techniques help easing the panic attack. Fourth is exposure therapy. In this therapy, the patient is placed in the situation that triggers his claustrophobia to overcome the fear. It focuses on idea that more the patient is exposed to his fear, the less he will fear it. Next, medications. Medications such as anti-anxiety medication or antidepressants such as SSRIs, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors are given. Next is the nursing management. As a nurse, what are the duties that should be done for a patient having claustrophobia? So the interventions are maintaining a calm, non-threatening manner while working with the client, establishing and maintaining a trusting relationship by listening to client, answering questions directly, being available and respecting the client's use of personal space, remaining with the client at all times when levels of anxiety are high, reassure client of his or her safety and security. So the person is having a psychotic disorder. Whenever he'll experience panic attack, the nurse should be there for him or her so that he can get a psychological support. Move the client to a quiet area with minimal stimuli such as a small room or seclusion area, dim lighting, few people and so on. Educate the patient that anxiety disorders are treatable. Many people think that anxiety is permanent or they will never get recovered from it, but we should educate them that they are treatable. Administer SSRIs and as ordered and encourage the patient participation in relaxation exercises such as deep breathing, progressive muscle relaxation, guided imagery and meditation. That's all about claustrophobia. Thank you so much for watching. Please like this video and I hope you all understood.
Do like, leave a comment and share with your friends.